Hello, Narnach here. Welcome back to Path of Exile. Patch 2.3.1 has landed upon us and it has reset the sound system. So I had to fill a little bit with the audio volumes. I think I got it about back to where this might be a bit louder. But yeah, things are slightly different. The devs are now so proud of their new sound system that they just reset the sound system across the board to the default settings. Just so everybody can experience it in its full glory. And I have to say, actually having the sound at a level where I can hear it rather than it being low enough that you can actually hear my voice, it is a nice experience. It's definitely a nice experience to be in town and hear background noises and footsteps and things like that. But no, I'm playing this in part it's pretty useful if you can actually hear my voice, so I had to mute it again. So life of being a YouTuber, don't always get to experience the sound part of a game in full glory. So I might now tweak with it for a little bit over the coming couple of episodes to see if I can raise or lower it a little bit, just to get it just right. That worked out beautifully. Shoot one Frostbolt, one Vortex, and it just kills them. Well, as always, we're not going to waste too much time on the Twilight Strand, but yeah, it is fun to kill those zombies every once in a while. Just warm up a little bit, so to say. That's you and you. Okay. Ooh, no nice big packs. Well, that's the main difference in Merciless, right? You get really large packs of zombies. Okay, so we frostbite you, bomb you, keep a distance, shoot you to bits. Let's see, I have to reapply that frost bomb, and he died before he could even say a leap slam. Poor Alec, he always gets the short end of the stick. So in the usual tradition, I'm gonna speed through this relatively fast, doing the main quests and doing the interesting bits and just getting back to the interesting parts of the game as soon as possible. That said, I am curious to see how the things like the fire breather that got added here, the special monsters. I'm quite sure if they got a name. I think they were initially referred to as elites, but I don't think they quite went with that name. But it's the special monsters. So in here there are fire breathers that we'll have to look out for. So far, things are progressing pretty swimmingly. Merville's favorites. Not quite sure if they were here before or not. Hey, hello there. Precise cannibal. Oh, you're just a torchbearer. Not actually flame breeders. So, just did a sound check, just running one of the daily master missions, and there the sound was fine, but it was just me versus Vegan, and he's not the most chatty of fellas. Got a feeling this is slightly louder. So, we'll have to see how it turns out. As I said, they made some changes to the audio settings, so gonna work with what I got, but maybe it turns out that when listening to it afterwards, things are actually going to be pretty nice, and then the upside will be that you'll actually get to hear a bit more of the game's audio while watching these episodes. It's on one hand, it is kind of unfortunate that most of the side quests that used to give skills in normal and cruel now only give you like rare gloves and boots and things like that. Most of the time the items aren't really terribly good. So it basically means that those quests are just not worth doing, or not worth focusing on. Which I think is a shame. I wonder if the if something different could be done to it. If no, you maybe could just get some currency. Maybe get, I don't know, alchemy orbs, chaos orbs, orbs of fusing. No, just useful late game currency. By now most people will have a reasonable collection of currency. Though 5 to 10 orbs of alchemy is something that you will probably naturally find. Similarly, 5 to 10 chaos orbs is not uncommon. Orbs of alchemy and orbs of transmutation is somewhere between 50 and 100. So, no, getting like one elk or one chaos, it would be more meaningful than getting a random rare glove, I think. Hello there, froggies. Apparently, the froggies are a bit bigger now. It was all the rave on Reddit today. People really excited about their frogs. Like, yeah, they're bigger now. At least this frog is happily jumping away. Ooh, that's a nice pack. Well, correction. That was a nice pack. Not a lot left of them. Let's see, level of control destruction. Let's see what's in here. Identified, quantity, quality, random curse. Okay. Let's cure that random curse. Ooh, you are standing there a bit off to the side, buddy. Can't have you running off. Really feel like going off. Ooh, back. Okay, it's out of curse range. It's actually seems to stay out of range. Good job there, Stone Golem, pulling it away from me. And oh, almost had it, but it collided with a tree. Yeah. Let's go back. So with the defensiveness stat boost from the labyrinth, and my gear being generally in pretty decent shape, I'm currently not really focusing on upgrading it yet. Back in Hardcore Perendis, I had this really nice body armor that I would have equipped if it was a 5 link. But upon reconsidering, this is pretty good. And given that this is a standard link, I've understood that it's a bit harder to trade for things. It's way more expensive, because this is the league that gets flooded with currency eventually. So as a result, prices are higher because currency is worth less. And though most people are playing the temporary leagues, so trade on the temporary leagues is also more liquid. It's easier to get stuff because people are playing there. In here, what I understand, not personal experience yet, what I understand, people are not always willing to leave their character in the Perendis League, or not Perendis League, in the Prophecy League, to move over to one of the permanent leagues in order to trade for something that's like maybe one chaos or less. So we'll see. But as I said, for now, in terms of defenses, I feel pretty good. I'm not gonna really bother with upgrading gear unless I accidentally find something, which no, can happen. And otherwise it's gonna be in Act 4. Then we'll do another pass with gear upgrades. Maybe we're at the point where we can do maps, where we can Malachi, run the labyrinth on Merciless. Things like that. Uh, Let's see. We find the staircase out, which means I'll return later on my own to do the Dweller of the Deeps. Because, oh, you see how fast I mow through content. That's just going to be more of the same. So I'd rather just advance a little bit, give you a feel for how this build at this power level behaves in the different aspects of the game. But I think the real challenge is going to kick in back when we are in maps. Hello there, Jimmies. Okay. Gem cutters, strong boxes are very nice to build up a supply of gems. Especially if you don't have a lot of characters in the league, or if it's your first character in the league. Those gem cutter strong boxes are a nice way to give you a random selection of gems. Because not every character can buy all the gems. Getting access to some off-class gems, so to say, in that way is kind of nice. It's also why I enjoy doing the Master Daily quests. Because once you get a Master to level 3, they'll start offering a random selection of 3 gems every day that you can buy from them. They're just going to be, you know, level 1 gems. They're not even leveled as they are from the other people. They have a chance to have quality on them, which is pretty nice. And the selection will only refresh once you do another daily quest. Or start a new daily quest, I think. You don't even have to complete it, you just have to start it to refresh the store. So, no, if you're playing like a witch, that's pure intelligence class, then doing Haku dailies is a pretty decent way to get access to red gems that you normally have a harder time getting access to. Or in my case, I'm a shadow, that's a dex int. Getting access to pure strength is similarly tricky. Or, no, summoning related skills are pretty difficult to get as a shadow, because, well, we get mostly combat stuff, but not summoning, because that's the witch's domain, apparently. But now that everybody kind of can have a golem and probably wants to have a golem, not getting access to the minion buffs, especially on a hybrid intelligence character, feels a little weird, but hey, we make do. And a lot of stuff you will be able to randomly find drops and things like that. That worked out pretty well. So. Yeah. This combo works pretty well. Especially with the larger packs, Vortex shines pretty brightly. And for single targets like Kuduku, oh yeah, Frostbolt, it works, it really rips through. Okay. Couple more. Hello there, Gluttonous Skull. Goodbye, Gluttonous Skull. Hello there, Vegan. Destroy more dummies, okay. Best fun you can have on your feet. As long as he keeps spawning them pretty near me, the Vortex is really, really useful for this. The increased AoE definitely helps out here. Hello there, Regan. I've said it before. And he got into level 5. Nice. Hello there, zombies. Or should I say popsicles? Popsicles? So, gonna be a waypoint around here somewhere. Useful to grab. And after that, we get the prison. And this is going to be merciless, so we'll need to do trials. Also, I realize I just walked past this waypoint, which might not be the brightest idea in the world. Okay, these guys are rather tough. Let's throw frostbolts at the problem. I mean, frostbolt currently 4000 DPS. Actually, just 7 points over it. That's due to the frenzy stuff. Okay, it had 4000. I did see it. It's only 3200, and this one is only 1500. Vortex is definitely it's good for dealing with groups of mobs, but it is not the most powerful tool you have at your disposal. That will remain Frostbolt, because that's what it's intended for. It's control versus damage. Nicely packaged into two different skills. Let's see, Rogue Exile, that's nice. That's you, Augustina Slira. Okay, let's actually drink our flask. And that was Augustina. I think I missed something up here. You. Yeah. Let's see, another stone. A golem. Five sockets. Well, not quite the item I'm looking for. That's the curse once you have decent items. Just randomly finding items that are upgrades becomes pretty difficult. Similarly, crafting items becomes pretty difficult because it's hard to top some good items. Hey, hello there. Iron points. And again, over here, Frostbolt is way more effective than Frost, than Vortex. Even though for trash mobs like this, Vortex is really nice to just clear most of them. And then Frostbolt is again for the details. Carnal boots, 55. Well, as I said, I'm not gonna really bother with items until level 68, when we first get into maps. Oof, that was nicely frozen in midair.
Just need a moment to catch my breath.
Let's see, want a lower prison.
Theopolis prison's a child's playhouse compared to this. They sure don't make the line used.
Let's empty our pockets for a little bit. As I said, here you get some rewards. Oh yeah, you actually get the choice between a 4-link white item for crafting purposes or a random rare with rubbish sockets. So I could say, well, we'll just take this one because it's useful or something. I don't know. Probably actually should have gone for the rare. It's easier to sell. Let's keep these for crafting. Anything actually useful? Compare the stats, this is not an upgrade. It's also not really good resists on this. Everything else is just nice to sell. Okay. Put things back in the box. Sorting. Let's be neat about this. Let's see, all the gems go in the sorting box. Cards as well. And then all the other currency. To the currency. Have a chat with Nessa. You got more stuff that you want to get rid of? Yes. Okay. So back to the prison. Oh, we got some time. So we got a trial here, and we got. Oh, that is convenient. Okay, so timed spikes. Okay. Some pressure pads. Ah, these are all timed. Timed crank. We can run around again. And this one's gonna come up. Oh wait, this is just timed as well. Timed crank, that's the original door. This is closed, so we walk back. All this timed stuff, this is pretty good. Wow, that was nice. Oh, room full of goodies. I think it was a 4 plus 2 link drop there. Yeah, 4 link and a 2 link. Pure evasion. 6 sockets, not bad though. Let's see, this one's gonna pop up. It's gonna go down. There we go here. There we go here. And we walk through and then we start blowing things to bits. Never make the mistake of trying to shoot while inside of here, because chances are you're gonna get yourself skewered. Presumably higher difficulties it will hurt more than lower difficulties, so you will get punished even more. Apparently I already had all of these trials completed on another character. So that means I get to skip the trials for the rest of this. That's nice. Actually also contemplating when we are in Act 3 of just doing the labyrinth while we are there rather than waiting for Act 4. Given that I can slightly abuse my newly acquired softcore status here, and that if I die, well, you know, that's life. That's not the end of the series. Hey there, one Haku. Hello, chatters. Well, yeah, you're not really walking out of here alive, mister. So, find the spirits. Well, we're standing on top of it, that's convenient. And now we just have infinite time to return it. Well, technically infinite time. Don't really wanna consider this infinite. Ooh, smoke clouds. Good thing is, I don't use accuracy, so I don't really care much about smoke clouds. I wonder if the blindness also sticks to our opponents. Ah, so far so good. Seems to be a rather high occurrence of otherworldly monsters over here. Maybe just one pack that was stringing out here. Okay, they summon spawns, they get frenzied, but they will just dive just fine. And more otherworldly. Yeah, I think this map might just be slightly haunted or something with otherworldly spirits. That's called the Haunted Trench for a reason, right? But it's a nice little bit of Act 3 wrapped up in a Haku area back in Act 1. Add some variety to the gameplay, which is good. But this is not why we came, why we were here. We are here to find the exits and then have a bit of a firm chat with the warden. I think he's making a little bit of a mess of this. A yellow spider. That's a sight. This build really does have a lot of power. And it's only going to get more of the charge as we progress and add damage to the build, because we are in our tanky shift form right now. Damage is to be added later. Add 3 tablespoons of damage. Then stir. Don't use a blender, just stir by hand. And eventually you will get a very, very nice result. Or something along those lines. And there is the exits. Upper prison. Cast damage when taken. One damage taken. That's always nice to find at level 1, because level 1 is actually the ideal level for that. Well, in terms of if you want to deal damage with it, then I think level 2 was the most optimal one. Someone did the math and it was effective damage percentage applied versus damage taken was the most effective at level 2. But if you just want to trigger it often, a level 1 cast when damage taken cannot be beaten. There is a damage reflector over there. Well, no more. Used to be there. If I were at the exits, where would I hide? Oh wait, this kind of structure. Ooh, a vessel cry. It is a nice skill. Making stuff explode in a purple cloud of chaos is always fun. And then over here. Hey, is that another Rogue Exile? It is. Hello there, Armios. Yeah, you don't really stand a chance. Even though my chance to evade is only, quote unquote, only 46%. Keep in mind that Enfeeble reduces their accuracy by 31%, which might actually make quite a big difference. Because it basically, you know, stacks with evasion in that regard. And after that, the damage is a bit on the weak end, because the damage is also reduced. Let's see. Elemental resistance, yeah. His resistances were high enough that even with a frost bomb, and I believe I managed to make the frostbite stick, it didn't actually sway him. Hey, sawbones. Okay, this is a bit of a dead end. Oh, and there is a yellow over here. Well, you just have to die, right? Powerful crits and hexproof. So, not impressed by aura. Curse aura, that is. Cold snap. This staircase only looks a little bit ominous. didn't really help him though. I swear there was a path over there, but it's not. And then here, I do have to work for finding the exit here. See, this just leads back, just double checking. Oh, there's an exit over there. We just need to find a way there. And you. Ooh, nice. Next level. So it begins. Extra damage. 3600. Ah, I get a damage bonus based on if my energy shield is full or not. So we see 3100 here currently. That didn't become 37 suddenly, but 32 something. Well, I have to kill things. So there's this bonus in Shade Form, 20% increased attack and cast speed if your energy shield recharge has started recently, as in the last 4 seconds. Which, well, if you get hit for little pinpricks, is quite often. Okay, I think we cleared things. So, what's the damage in a stable state once this one wears off? 32. So I went from 31 to 3200. But there will be more. So I think eventually we'll reach about 4000 DPS flat. Sort of something like that. It moves like a killer, yet reeks of thaumaturgy. So Piety is fascinated with the shadow. Killer plus thaumaturgy. Never really noticed that line of dialogue. Summoner. Interesting. So it is worth blowing up barrels here. And opening chests and stuff like that. Wonder if it's all difficulties or if it's only merciless. Let's see. Hello there, ratties. Hello there, warden. Oh, have some minions. Just need a moment. Frostbite him, bomb him, and then just blow him to bits. Bomb him, frostbite him, keep shooting. I wanna get away from you so I can actually frostbite you, mister. Boom. Big just means more places to stick a blade. And we grab that one, and then that is, well, that's it. So next episode we're gonna go after Lady Mervale and probably do the first little bit of Act 2. The rate we are progressing right now, I think we're gonna make a very, very fine speed here, which is nice since your speed matches the challenge level that the game provides your character, and you will usually just blaze past the things that you are overpowered for, and then once you start meeting resistance, which here is usually Act 3 or Act 4, then you slow down a little bit again and you actually have to work for your kills and your XP and your loot. But with that, I'm gonna thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again next time. Bye bye.